Hey guys, it's Morgan. Oh man, if you want to know the backstory and that laughing, message me. I will let you know. Anyway, I have been given the go-ahead by Mr. Garrett Anderson to take a ball peen hammer to his radiators on the Beta 200RR. If you guys watched the last video, which I called the final video, but now this is going to be the final. Anyway, whatever. We're still messing with it. The one fault that I could find in this Beta, honestly, besides the clutch noise, which I really am just not even considering a fault because it does not affect the way it runs or works or any of that stuff. The one real fault I could find is the steering radius. It's not a big deal when you're riding normal trails, but if you get in the really tight stuff or actually just pushing it around the shop, it's pretty annoying because under normal conditions, you have to run the stops out this far so that the fork doesn't hit the top of the radiator. Same over here. This is maybe a little bit easier to see. Hang on. So Garrett has them about as tight as you can go. So we've got these guards, which I'm hoping are going to be far enough out of the way. What we're going to do is I'm going to take the steering stops out. We're going to pull it back, see where it hits. We're going to take a ball peen hammer to it. We're going to clearance the radiators and see if we can get rid of those stops or push them all the way in without the nuts and get a better turning radius. So if that sounds like fun, you want to watch me take a hammer to my good friend's motorcycle, join us. Here we go. Okay, so I have the steering lock out of this side. Now you don't want to just go bare in here with nothing, because when the steering, if you get this all working and it's not hitting the radiators, the triple clamp is going to hit there, and if it's just bare like that, it'll damage this, which will also damage the triple clamp. So what we want to do is be able to remove this nut and run this all the way in. All right, we've got the stops all the way run in, and as I bring it over here, you guys aren't going to really be able to see this, but this bolt is actually hitting on the radiator guard. You can see right there. I don't know if you guys can see. Yeah, you can see it right there. So I'm going to take a die grinder with a little burr bit, and we're going to shave that down first. All right, guys, I got the, I have the radiator guard ground out enough that now the fork is hitting. So I got my little marker here. We're just gonna mark right. All right. Gonna start with our little bitty ball peen hammer, and we're just gonna. All right, I'm gonna go grab my bigger hammer. All right, now the nut or the bolt is hitting again. We're just gonna keep going back and forth. I'm not gonna film all this. I'm gonna keep going back and forth until we get that thing to go all the way to the lock. So I'll bring you back in when we get it done and see how far you have to go. We got it, guys. So I ended up having to beat this in just a little bit with the ball peen hammer. Turns out pretty nice, did a decent job with that. And then we had to grind down a fair amount on the radiator brace here for this to clear. And I ended up actually clearancing the bolt just a tiny bit because it was a little bit easier than continuing to grind on this. Also had to grind a little bit out of here for the rest of that. You can see it gets really close, but now it goes full lock and everything's awesome. So I'm gonna do the other side and we'll check in and see what it all looks like together. But I'm really, really happy about this because it was like, honestly, like the only thing that was kind of like not my favorite. Okay, so guys, as I'm working on this side, I'm finding that what really helps is to, when you you know, you got this out of the way, this is clearance for this, and now we're hitting the radiator brace again, it really helps to just slam it once, comes in here and it makes a mark. Whoops, sorry. And it makes a mark right there. There you can see it. So you know exactly where you got to grind. Also, this wheel is doing way better job than that burr. The burr was getting clogged up with aluminum, so. Guys, we got it all dialed in. It took a little bit more grinding on this side. Had to grind one of the little nubbins off of the radiator cap, but still definitely easily to get a hold of it and turn it off. See, there we go. No problems. But we clearanced this in with the ball peen hammer. Took this with the grinder. Still plenty of structural integrity here. Now this bike will go full lock both sides. Really happy. It actually kind of hits on this hose here, but I don't know a better way to route it, unfortunately. Let me see if I can try something here real fast. Guys, we got it all dialed in. It took a little bit more grinding on this side. Had to grind one of the little nubbins off of the radiator cap, but still definitely easily to get a hold of it and turn it off. See, there we go. No problems. But we clearanced this in with the ball peen hammer. Took this with the grinder. Still plenty of structural integrity here. Now this bike will go full lock both sides. Really happy. It actually kind of hits on this hose here, but I don't know a better way to route it, unfortunately. Let me see if I can try something here real fast. There we go. So that works just fine. Routes, still goes down and out to the ground like it's supposed to. Actually might give me a little more room to do a little more grinding. I get that a little bit further back because it is, when I hit hard, it does hit the lock, but it definitely is still hitting on the guard. I think the radiator is out of the way. Let's maybe a couple little things. Let me clean that up a little bit more, see if we can get just a tiny bit better. All right, yeah, I got that better. Was able to shave just a little more off of everything, get this routed, beat that back in just a little bit, and now this thing goes full lock, both sides. Actually really happy. I gotta get out and ride this thing again and check that out, because that seriously was the only real complaint. The clutch noise is just not that big a deal, and it's better now, I think, with my mod. Probably get better with maybe real high-end set of plates or maybe a whole billet situation. I don't know, but I wouldn't worry about it. For mine, I'm not worrying about it. I'm just gonna go ride the thing. Super stoked, guys. Hope that helps. Yeah, it's not real pretty. And yes, the bike is dirty. I know somebody's, you ride it in the back. It snowed like 2 inches last night. It's cold and crap. I don't need to clean the bike to beat on it and grind on it with a die grinder. I will now, however, wash it once it does warm up a little bit for Garrett so he can come pick it back up and get out and ride this thing. I think it's better than it was. Pretty happy about that. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. Make sure you subscribe and all the YouTube-y things, like, comments, all those things, because it helps us out, and we're getting close to 20,000 subscribers. And when we hit that, we're choosing one of you lucky subscribers to bring you out here to ride with us. You get to ride the Game Changer and my other bike, and I'm gonna go have fun. It's gonna be awesome. So yeah, thanks guys. See you on the next one.